The new version of Flutter, Flutter 3.7, has already hit the stable channel and is ready to be downloaded and used. It contains new interesting features and also comes loaded with performance improvements for your Flutter apps. Let's take a quick look at what Flutter 3.7 has to offer. The migration of the Material Visual Standard from version 2 to version 3 has taken giant steps in this new version. We have a bunch of migrated widgets that you can try right away by setting the Use Material 3 flag to true in your theme data. You can quickly and easily see how all the visual components look in the Material 3 version in the official example. As always, I leave you the link in the video description. We also have the new rendering engine for Flutter, Impeller, which promises to improve the performance of Flutter apps, especially on Apple devices, where we have the famous jank issues caused by shader compilations. Impeller was previously available in preview on the master channel, and can now be activated in this new version without changing channels. Please note that it is not ready for production yet, and it's still in preview. The Flutter team has commented that in future releases, we will be able to see it in preview mode for Android as well. We also now have a new way to create menu bars for desktop-oriented applications. For example, the new Platform Menu Bar widget has been added that will allow us to create macOS-style menu bars. We will be able to interact between these bars and our application, define shortcuts, etc. If you want a global menu for all platforms based on Material, you can use the Menu Bar widget instead. A small feature that can improve the accessibility of our applications enormously is the possibility of enjoying the magnifying glass now working at full power in the text fields of our application. These types of features are those that usually go unnoticed, but I think that it greatly enriches the quality of our applications. Regarding iOS development, a series of checks have been added that are executed when you want to deploy your application to the App Store. These checks will verify your bundle ID, your app icons, among other things, to help you see if you meet all the necessary requirements to upload your app. Also, as I announced in a previous video, the Cupertino List section and Cupertino List Style widgets have now been added to the stable branch, which are the counterparts to List Style in Material for creating lists of items in the Cupertino Visual Style. Undoubtedly a great improvement to be able to give iOS builds a look and feel more in line with what native applications offer. This version also offers general performance improvements, as some Reddit users have been able to notice. It's important and notable to see that even though a new graphical backend is being developed, Impeller, the Flutter team and their contributors are still improving the current renderer and applying efficiency improvements where possible. So, thank you very much for this great work that you are carrying out. And here ends this quick summary of what Flutter 3.7 offers. If you want to know more, I leave you the link to the official blog post where you will see in more detail everything explained here and more. Thank you very much for joining me in this summary. Leave me a like if you liked it and consider subscribing for more content on mobile development, hardware reviews, and much more. I'll see you soon. Goodbye.